we get so wrapped up into our own businesses that we don't notice the trends that affect us or those competitors who are hiding in our blind spot. I've got some ideas on how to do that. I want you to go to the wrong meetings. I'm not completely serious about this. If you're only going to Orange Theory meetings, you are missing what's happening in 95% of the world. And the 95% of the world that will affect you. I want you to come to a big hotel like this and look at that board and see who else is having a meeting, and then I want you to walk in and crash it. I do. I want you to come in and sit down. You'll say, well, I can't do that. I don't have a badge. You know, I can't do that. You don't need a badge. There are no badge police out looking for you. Look how many people are in here. You just walk in with everybody else. You take a notepad and your pen and you start taking notes about things that are happening in our culture. Here's a good example. This is the CVS Pharmacy, and they have 6,000 locations. And so I'm in Toronto, and they're celebrating their 50th anniversary. The chief operating officer stands at the podium, and he says this: hey, thanks a lot, everybody. You're doing a great job out there. You know, we have made some changes in the way we're going to treat our customers. And so you're going to find that, and you'll get a notice, that from now on, we're no longer going to be putting the back pain medications on the low shelves. Are you kidding me? For 50 years, you're making these people go in there, no, I can get it. I got that. I got it. Oh, I got it. What's the lesson there? The lesson is, when we do things, we do them over and over and over without regard for a member, without regard for the client or the customer, because this, it's easier for us. We need to think about what their experience is every single step of the way. Oh, I encourage audiences to look outside of your own industry for inspiration, because when you do, something weird happens. You realize that you've been overthinking solutions.
You always get your pet deposits?
Yes, sir, I do.
Where are you from?
I'm from San Antonio, Texas. I'm managing 67 units out there.
And you're getting your pet, tell us, how do we get our pet deposits?
You know, sir, I made an investment and I bought myself a dog whistle. I just walk up and down the halls blowing my whistle. I find them dogs.
Oh, man. You know what this is? This is a perfect example of underthinking a solution, isn't it?
Sometimes we overthink what the solution is, and we don't need to. We need to get as close to the member, close to the customer as we can, and we can just see it. It's obvious. For the cost of a dog whistle for $374, or if you want a used one, it's $499. You see that?
Well, some of the most critical decisions any leader or company can make is to abandon obsolete processes and obsolete habits, especially those that concern how our customers and our members and our clients expect to be treated today.
We've always been taught to wow our customers, haven't we? I've been making HR training films since 1999, and that's what we said. We've got to make an impression on people. We have to wow them. They have to have such an emotional reaction they'll tell their friends.
Wowing people does not cause loyalty.
It is the elimination of the pow moments. The gut punches we deliver to the customer when we disappoint them. We don't live up to our brand promise. We don't do what we said we'd do.
Place I went back to my hometown, and there's a Toyota dealership there. They've installed this cookie machine. It's an Otis Spunkmeyer, makes fresh cookies. They thought, well, the smell of a cookie will draw people into the parking spot. Okay, isn't that a wow moment?
That wow moment is not going to overcome a potential pow. For example, you're standing at the service desk and you're explaining something to a client.
You know, we went through your Land Cruiser and it's going to need a new transmission, that's $3,600, and installation, that's another $795. You want a cookie?
I should tell you, I'm doing this story from my room at the Cosmopolitan Hotel in Las Vegas, where I just interviewed actor and activist Alec Baldwin at the Chelsea Theater. We talked for about an hour in front of 2,300 people. Because of all my years as a network talk show host, I make celebrities and senior leaders feel comfortable
whether it's a one-on-one interview or moderating a panel. I'm in Panama City.